Ladies and gents, I'm taking a break from the review of the room and I'm doing a review requested by a friend. The review is special, and I do mean special, since it's for the special named the Star Wars Holiday Special. Our story starts with the Millennium Falcon being piloted by Han Solo and Chewbacca sitting right beside him. And they're going to Chewie's home. Why are you going to Chewie's home? To celebrate. I actually had some of this in preparation. To celebrate Life Day. So suddenly, two Star Destroyers drop by.
That's it, I'm turning back.
But Chewie manages to change his mind by saying this.
I know your family's waiting.
I know it's an important day.
All right, we'll give it a try.
I'll set your coordinates.
Won't jump far. I'll get you back there in time, pal. Trust me. Our only hope now is I'll run that Imperial garbage scout. I'm going to Lightspeed.
That's the spirit. You'll be celebrating Life Day before you know it.
By the way, thanks Han Solo for making this moment understandable. I mean, if I were forced to watch just Wookiees roaring for 80 minutes, it would be like going through hell for me.
The Star Wars Holiday Special. Starring Mark Hamill as Luke Skywalker.
Oh, hi Barbie Luke. Sorry, couldn't resist. Even though I kind of feel really bad for him since he was in a car accident and this was their way of covering up the damage it caused to him. So, yeah. Not going to make too many remarks on that.
Harrison Ford as Han Solo. Carrie Fisher as Princess Leia. With Anthony Daniels as C-3PO. Peter Mayhew as Chewbacca. R2-D2 as R2-D2.
So, I'm guessing they stopped crediting the main cast here?
And James Earl Jones as the voice of Darth Vader.
Great! James Earl Jones finally gets a credit for the voice of Darth Vader, and it's for this shit! Oh man, oh god.
Introducing Chewbacca's family, his wife Mala, his father Itchy, his son Lumpy, with special guest stars, Beatrice Arthur, Art Carney, Diane Carroll, the Jefferson Starship, Corman.
Oh, it looks like special guest stars gets credits, but the actor that plays R2-D2 doesn't for some reason.
And an animated Star Wars story on the Star Wars Holiday Special.
High painting that's supposed to be Chewie's home? So yeah, I'm guessing they were on a really tight budget. Once inside, we get to see that they live just like us. Anyway. Hey, it's Chewie's son, Lumpy. I wonder if that name says something about the kid or the state his dad was in when he... Never mind, I don't even want to think about that. Good stuff. And there's Grandpa Itchy. I'm guessing he got that name because of the look that he constantly gives. I mean, it looks like he has a really bad itch he wants to scratch. There's Mrs. Chewie. Mala. It might as well be Lala. And she's in her natural habitat. the kitchen. Just like here, we also have a roch in the kitchen. Wait a second, I just realized something. The only English I got so far is from Han Solo. And he didn't have that many lines. Oh, fuck. This is going to be 80 minutes of... Let's just get through this. By the way, please. Please. Please let there be subtitles in this movie because I really don't speak Wookiegasms. Lumpy has to do a chore, and after that chore, he puts his lamp on. Apparently, green screen danger. So, Grandpa Itchy decides to stop carving X-Wings out of woods. I don't know why, but it causes some seriously cognitive dissonance when I think of Grandpa Itchy with that look and woods. Maybe it's just me. And he decides to take a look at Chewie's picture together with Marla. Let the circus begin. So we get the seaweed guy introducing us to flexible aliens, acrobacy, juggling, and really does this by blowing his trumpets. Oh boy, that blows. English! Woohoo!
Here, keep working on it. Hello, Mala! Itchy? Hiya, Lumpy. Where's Chewbacca? What's up? It's Chewbacca. Yeah, we'll bring him to the screen. I want to say hello to him. You don't know where he is? Oh, he's not there yet. Is that it? Well, all I can tell you is that he and Han left here on schedule. If he's not there now, they're way overdue. So there must have been trouble. R2, please, this is important. Now listen, calm down. I mean, you know how Han and Chewbacca are. Anything could have happened. They could have stopped off somewhere or been held up by an asteroid storm. Listen. I wouldn't worry about Chewbacca. I know him, and he hasn't missed a life day yet, right? Well, there you go. He's not going to miss this one either. It's just taking him a little bit longer to get there, that's all. He'll make it. Come on, don't look so worried. Now, Chewie's not going to want to come home to a house full of long faces, is he? Come on, Mala, let's see a little smile.
And doesn't he look cute? Oh, come on, Luke. Beat those eyelashes one more time. That will turn their growl into an... More happy growl?
There, that's better. Try to enjoy your life day. I gotta get back to this engine. I think we might have it solved.
Have fun fixing your engine!
No! R2! What are you doing? that, will you? Oh, no.
Off in smoky goes.
You want to see my identification?
No, I'm off duty. I've come to look around your shop.
Oh my god. It's the off-duty Imperial Guard's evil McStashian, who doesn't give a fuck, cause he's evil, and he has the badass low voice. And the stash, and he is off-duty.
Look around. Browse around. Make yourself to home. As you can see, I've got just about everything a man or Wookiee would want. Come here. Let me show you this. I really love this. Ah, here we are. Here it is. A pocket-sized aquarium. Wonderful, isn't it? And you can take it with you anywhere. And the tank is a snap to clean.
I hate fish.
Well, so do I, as a matter of fact. I take a drink once in a while, but I just thought I'd show you some of the stupid stuff those Wookiees purchased from me.
Solo, give it up. Evil McStashian doesn't give a shit. He's like the honey badger. He don't give a shit.
Oh, here. Here's a hot little item that seems to be moving pretty rapidly these days.
Excuse me. Got a wall screen customer. Good to see you again. Don't say a word, madam. I know just why you're calling. You're wondering when that shaggy carpet you ordered will arrive at your home. Let me assure you, madam, it's on its way. You know, it was made especially for you by a little old woman four planets away. She did it all by herself. In fact, you might say she did it by hand. Solo.
Whoa! Man! You almost fooled me with that obvious way of selling that bullshit. She did it by hand. Solo. That was clever!
Though it's gonna take some time to get to you. I know you understand. Understand, don't you? Terrific. By the way, I'll be by later to drop off that extra proton energy pack.
Proton energy packs? Proton energy packs? I thought that was a Ghostbusters thing. Are they going to celebrate Life Day by going Ghostbusters on us?
You're welcome.
What's the matter? Would you like this?
It's just a groomer.
Just a groomer?
A groomer.
Just a groomer, you say? A lot more than that. Evidently, you haven't read the instructions of the warranty and the guarantee.
Besides shaving and hair trimming, it's guaranteed to lift stains off clothing, faces, and hands. Cleans teeth, fingers, and toenails, washes eyes, pierces ears, calculates, modulates, and syncopates life rhythms, and can repeat the entire Imperial Penal Code, all 17 volumes, in half the time of the old XP-21. Just the thing to keep you squeaky clean.
Wow. That's handy. You know, MacGyver should use one of those.
I use one of these all the time.
Really?
Well, not all the time, but some of the time. Oh, another outstanding feature of this little model. You can recharge it by simply plugging it into any ordinary laser outlet.
I'll take it.
Good, I thought you would. Now, would you like to pay me something for it, or give me something in trade?
I said I'll take it.
He took it without paying? Hey guys, join the dark side. Take whatever you want for free. And that includes cookies. Chocolate cookies.
That's a load off my mind. I thought I might embarrass you when I told you to accept it as a gift. I don't like embarrassing people. I don't like being embarrassed myself. That's why I don't like to embarrass people.
Yeah, poor Sodom, unwillingly giving out holiday gifts.
I just said that. Just a rumor.
Hey, there's Darth Vader.
We ordered a blockade and a curfew and started a search operation.
Wait a second. The lips, they don't match up. They really don't. Look! I can't really say for Darth Vader, but the dude besides him, yeah, they don't match up.
It's just a matter of time before we find the rebels.
I know that scene. That's from Star Wars Episode 4, A New Hope. They just overdubbed it with this shit.
I want the rebels located and identified, if it means searching every household in the system.
So, moving on.
Today we are going to be preparing a very succulent dish called Bantha Surprise.
Oh, it's a cooking show.
A very hearty, nourishing dish, but it's very economical too. So all those hungry mouths in your household will be going yummy yum on their tummy tum if you just follow along with me as I prepare this popular favorite. Now, today, I'm going to be using the tenderest cut of the bantha, the loin. The loin is very tasty and serves four nicely. Of course, if your family has a hearty appetite, I would suggest then that old popular holiday favorite, the bantha rump. Very tender. Now we just slice into bite-sized morsels. But only you know the size of a bite in your family, eh? All right. Now it's time to put our chunks into our pots. We add a dash of legamo. Very good. Sprig of celery. Very nice. Little bit of tertium. Always nice. And, tertium is nice. And just a little whisper of chelto. Oh, looking very nice. Guess what I forgot? A bit of the calorantrum root. Wonderful. Just adds that touch of piquancy. There we go. Very nice.
So far, so good, I guess. Very nice.
Now we add enough liquid to cover. And guess what we are ready for now? The cooking. Step one, we stir the mixture. Stir, 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 stir. Stir, 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 stir. Very nice. Now, step two, while we're stirring, we also whip. So it's stir, whip, stir, whip, 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 stir. Stir, whip, stir, whip, 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 stir. Now, let's try it again together at an increased tempo, because precision is very important in this recipe, and we do want to have a fine consistency, don't we? So, and on the count of one. Stir, whip, stir, whip, 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 stir. Stir, whip, stir, whip.
A gourmanda, seriously? Calm down.
Whip, whip, stir. Come on, faster all together now. Cooking can be fun. Stir, whip, stir, whip, 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 stir. Stir, whip, stir, whip, whip, whip.
Chef Gourmanda, your hair is flying everywhere. Calm the fuck down. What is she on, yayo?
Having fun, having fun, all right?
At least I'm on alcohol, but what the fuck is she on?
Coming along nicely now. Step three. We also have to beat. So, it's...
Where the fuck did that turret arm come from?
Beat, 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 stir, whip, stir, whip, beat, beat, stir. That's not right. I'm sorry. Stir, whip, stir, whip, 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 stir, beat, stir, whip, stir, whip, 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 stir, beat. Coming along nicely. Starting to have a fine aroma.
And there's another one!
Dakota just in time. Now, at this time, I usually like to taste the broth, so we'll have a little taste and see how it's coming along. A little bit more, sir. So, a bit more agave, a little panko. One for the pot. Coming along. Very nice. Oh, wonderful. Coming along nicely.
Mm-hmm.